have this long-term vision of wanting to see Thailand a developed country. And therefore, we have been campaigning in a very quiet academic way that Thailand should leave the middle-income trap, move forward to become a high-income country. People like Thailand. We are fortunate because the Thai people are quite nice people. They're very friendly, our food are very nice.
สวัสดีค่ะ Welcome to Thailand Today program. I'm Kusuma Yothasmut. In line with the 20-year national strategy, the government stated that it is crucial for Thailand to have clear directions for long-term development. The Prime Minister also said, when Thailand is entering the fourth industrial revolution, known as Thailand 4.0 consciousness, and public minds are needed in order to everyone to move the country forward for a better future. What strategy for efficient national development to help the country achieve better economic growth in the future and for the future prosperity of Thailand? Today our program will discuss with Professor Dr. Krengsak Jareun Wongsak, a well-known scholar who established the first Future Studies Research Institute in Southeast Asia, focusing on promoting national development. Please join me to welcome Professor Dr. Krengsak Jareun Wongsak. He's the president of the Institute for Future Studies for Development in Thailand. Swadika.
Swadika.
Welcome to Thailand to the program, sir.
I'm very happy to be here.
Lovely, because we need you to be here because you are bringing something new. Because in line with the 20-year strategy, national strategy of the government, you're going to do something for development. So tell me before we get into that particular topic today, we talk about development direction or and the future of Thailand. Tell me, because you are the president of this institute and you created it by yourself.
You built it. About 30 years ago.
30 years
ago. It's a very old institute now, as old as some of us sitting here. So we have this long-term vision of wanting to see Thailand a developed country. And therefore, we have been campaigning in a very quiet academic way that Thailand should leave the middle-income trap, move forward to become a high-income country. For 30 years, we have said this, and we're thankful to this government for the first time in the last couple of years that the government is pushing the agenda of making Thailand a high-income country for once. And it looks tough, because by any record from the World Bank study, on if we grow at this rate, it probably will take about 30 years for Thailand to attain the bottom level of the high-income country status, which is going to be too long, because by that time it will be 92. So it will be too long. We should not wait that long. But anyway, at least we have a chance if we know how to conduct ourselves. But I want to speed it up. I really like to see it. At least we gain some ground that those in high power in the government for the very first time are taking this seriously. I wrote a book recently with many friends from who are foreigners, published in New York and London. And the part that I wrote is Thailand's strategy for high-income country. And therefore, it's supportive of what is going to be done. I talked this for 30 years. Now we have clear strategy to be advocating, and the government is seriously taking it. I hope that something can be done at least in the next few years.
You talk about institute, that means that someone's gone to study here.
We have done a lot of studies. In fact, recently, a few days ago, we have an international conference on nation building. And we present a important paper among a number of keynote plenary speeches. One is that, how can we move Thailand forward to become high income status? And how do we able to move Thailand in a much more realistic way to go forward? So that's one paper. We also have a paper of measuring national effectiveness index, countries' effectiveness index, in comparison to other countries, at least our neighbors, the six major ASEAN countries, mm-hmm. the core ASEAN, mm-hmm. and see which part, which components, mm-hmm. how are we doing mm-hmm. compared to one another, mm-hmm. relative to one another, mm-hmm. How are we doing in terms of effectiveness. Mm-hmm. And that is important to gauge mm-hmm. how we are in view of the long term we are going. Mm-hmm. So those are the, for example, the two research pieces mm-hmm. that were just presented mm-hmm. Just a few days ago mm-hmm. in Thailand, uh-huh. where people come from all over, many other countries that come and join us, mm-hmm. presenting academic papers at the same time, advocating key ideas.
Mm-hmm. But this key idea, is there, because you create this idea and trying to push it, that means you see the ability, you see the capability of the Thai people, of the country of Thailand?
I think Thailand has a tremendous opportunity if we know how to do the right thing. Mm. We are situated in a very central area mm. of ASEAN. We are the second largest economy of ASEAN. Mm. We have been very well established. While many of our friends are in many troubles, they were under the communist regime, so they delayed the development process in a market-based way for decades. We were there, we are free, we weren't under communism at that time. We have a chance to develop first, and we are an area we don't have too much disasters apart from man-made. We don't have volcano, we don't have all the big typhoon, the storm, we don't have
earthquake.
we don't have earthquake. So Thailand is centrally located. We have our borders connected to most of the ASEAN countries. Our borders are longest compared to any other 9 other ASEAN countries' borders with ASEAN. Mm-hmm. We are the hub of airport hub by legitimacy. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Every airline would seek to land here to go to the region, and we are the sort of infrastructure we have are not bad compared to many of our developing neighbors. We are attached to the fastest growing region of the world, including the CLMV, the newer ASEAN members who are growing fast. We are near China, we are near India. So Thailand stood in a well-placed position to be able to push it forward if we know what to do with our people and our system properly. In fact, we look back into the history of the last 40, 50 years. If we do the right thing by today, we should have done much better. And even with many problems, we put it for ourselves, put obstacles there for ourselves and hurdles that make us have to go through ourselves. Yet we're not doing too badly. Just imagine if we do it right all the time, what would happen? Today, we'll probably do as well as Singapore. I always say that Singapore was so smart by Lee Kuan Yew in knowing how to strategically move a very small nation with tiny resources forward by learning how to put a bet on the right strategic reasoning behind the development path. If Thailand know how to do it in different ways for the past 40, 50 years, we should be on par with Singapore. But today we're not. Therefore, we have to congratulate our neighbor for doing so well. But let's catch up. Let's do something. I do have high hope for our country. I think the main problem is how to make all of us think on the same wavelength and unify our effort together instead of keep internal division and problems internally for the last many years that produce hiccup and produce political hiccup, produce economic difficulties, produce social upheaval. I think if we know how to handle it well and be reasonable and be noble about it, Thailand should move forward in the next many years.
So what do you do about human resources? We don't talk about the conflict and all that between the colors.
Human
resources, the language, the way how people ambitious to grow up.
You know, Thailand, our people are on average are not any less in terms of intelligence compared to other people.
Exactly.
The problem is the education system are not too bad, but it's not too good either. We're spending a lot of money, but we don't do it wisely to produce the results. So I'm hoping there will be a better push forward of our education reformed so that we can produce a real outcome, not just going through the process and producing educational output that doesn't link with outcome. We want to make our people competent in every way. It's not only knowledge, but producing skills, producing character qualities that would make it conducive to be raw material to build our nation. So I think if we fix that and get it much better, we will have a chance. I don't think we are any way behind. Educationally, we can do better. Language, yes, Thai people have been very shy in using the English language. We but have been very much wanting to speak our own language, but it's getting better. If we just put the emphasis on it and we really engineer a better program to at least reform the language system to make our instruction of language in schools effective, I'm hoping. I'm hopeful that things can happen.
Me too. Yes, because for our audience in 177 countries worldwide, you may know that because Thailand is moving forward in many ways, and we all know fully well that we are capable to do so. So let's come back with this Nation Building Institute. This is big things because you're building a nation. So what is your strategy for national development to make a new start?
Let me tell you about Nation Building Institute. I found this idea based on a lot of internal contemplation. 250 years ago, when the world has industrialization, I don't think the world are prepared for a big market yet. Because after industrialization, industrial revolution, the market become very big. We have the steam engine that propel the factory, propel train to move goods and services and people across a longer distance, not going through traditional way of having carriage, horse and donkeys and people. Therefore, the market become very big. By that time, the science of economics were founded eventually by Adam Smith, but we still don't know how to handle the business world because we used to be domesticated in a very small area.
Exactly.
The whole linkage of selling, buyings through the old ancient trades are very much primitive. But after the industrial revolution, the market become very big, but we don't know how to do it. Therefore, university again start to have executive program to train people to do the business. And eventually, a few years later, the formal business school happened. Masters of Business Administration become a standard degree across all universities eventually in the past just over 100 years. I'm giving a new ideas. I say, okay, the last 100 years in this world, we have 200 and say roughly 40 nations and territories in the world. Only a handful have attained the status of high income country. To be exact, 13 countries have attained it. That means majority don't know how to do it. And out of that 13 countries, two or three are fortunate enough to find some natural resource like oil that make them able to attain the status by luck, but very few are by pure strategic brains to think of how to move their nation forward to be a high income country. I'm thinking that we need an academic institution that train people researching, training, teaching about nation building. Nation building doesn't mean we don't have a nation. It's an ongoing process. It doesn't mean there's something wrong that you have to fix all the time. It means that you continue to improve the status of your nation so that you build to elevate it to a level of a noble civility as a country which is at a high level where it should be. So Nation Building Institute is founded on that basis. I become the chairman of this. And then we start structure a program to train top level people from all sectors, public sector, people sector, private sectors, combined together in training in leadership, management, and morality, so that we can propel forward the three pillars: economics, politics, and societal, so that it have long-term sustainable development. So that's the idea, and we create an executive program recently for people who are high-level people, like ministers, deputy prime ministers who have been in the cabinet, people with a permanent secretary of various ministries, director general of different departments in the public sector, the constitutional bodies, the independent bodies, who are people who need, who want to understand how to work together, the private sector, big business, small businesses.
Is it being here? The institute is in Bangkok?
In Bangkok. In fact, we start in Bangkok so that one day in the fine long term, 200 years from now, they say the history is created in Thailand. Because there is the first institute of nation building right here in Bangkok, Thailand, training executive program. We already launched it. We have finished the first batch already. The second batch is coming.
Can you name some of the people for the batches?
The people who came to the program, we have former Deputy Prime Minister Kon Thaplangsi, who was minister for 7 or 8 ministries over his career, long decades of his career. We have former Deputy Prime Minister, Acting Prime Minister Chavalat Chanvilakun. We have Minister Dr. Nalini Thawisin, minister attached to the Prime Minister's office.
Very interesting.
The trade rep, trade representative of Thailand. We have Minister of ICT, Lanong Lak. We have the various government civil servants at top level. And we have also
How is curriculum?
The curriculum is strategy. Strategy in every way integrated to move the nation forward. Categorize them into public sector kind of ideas, private sector, the business sector, the people sector, on leadership, management, and morality. For example, the private sector, we talk about business strategy for nation building. Or another topic, how to grow family business to world class for nation building. From the public sector, we may talk about international relations strategy for nation building. We may talk about economic strategies for nation building. These are, for example, topics. And all kind of topics around this framework have been designed so that people can discuss, can hear ideas, can bring a roadmap and blueprint so that we can move in synergy forward. I'm hopeful. I'm really hopeful that by doing this years after years, batches after batches, we will see a community of people, nation builders. It will not just be a course that is being repeated over many batches, but it will become a result of this would be people who are well equipped in their thoughts, so that they will become community, a structured community where we could work with them. I'm hoping it will be a major institution of Thailand for nation building. I'm hoping that eventually we can draw upon these people to make them become instrumental in nation building of Thailand.
Listen to Professor Dr. Kreng Sak. I'm sure because he's going to get into this crucial part of Thailand in a very clear direction.
Thank
you. So, well, at present, as we all know, that challenges as to many countries that worldwide, how to attract much for foreign investment to come to the country. So maybe your institute also drawing the people can draw attention for that.
Yes, you know, in any countries, when you save enough, you will be able to use your internal resource for investment. That's first part. But for you to want to grow more, if we can avail ourselves with more resources from outside, and foreign investment come in as an additional part, which is and could be very major, could be much bigger than your internal investment even. If we can do that, and we do it in an attractive way that people willingly want to come, then we have a chance to enlarge our economic activities and our economy can grow faster, grow bigger. Therefore, the basic nuts and bolts of how to draw investment is very simple. Investment seek return. If you are doing something right and you give them assurance and security knowing that if they invest here, they will get good return. It will be sustainable return, it will be secure return, and it will be friendly to investor. It will not be a lot of huge burden, a lot of bother. the
rules and regulations to be
rules and regulation are very friendly and very streamlined, and it will be ease of doing business is there. People don't have to go through piles of documents, long times to register companies, difficult to get their tax return,
work permit,
and work permit. You don't have to write out the same thing over and over every year, piles of documents. If we know how to do that, I'm sure we can do it if we really want to. So far we are getting better, but not quite fully. But I think, just imagine if we do it fully, what will happen. I'm hopeful that we would be sensible to continue to move that direction.
I think this government is trying so hard.
Yes.
Because I have tried many ways that we Thai people hardly feel it, hardly get it, or even the foreign people, they may not understand the situation, but I think we're going to move on.
Yes, let's make the utmost effort to move that direction.
Yeah.
I am dreaming and hoping that Thailand would be the most friendly region of the world for investment, where people will come in and say, yeah, I'm very happy to be here because things
are... already said, but again, it's the Thai people and also the Kingdom of Thailand. Rule the regulation to be eased up, to be what you call to make them feel good.
Yes, I think discretionary kind of decision by those in authority should be the minimum, and allow the market to freely flow. Let the market determine more rather than regulation that bind and stifle people's imagination and creativity. I think people like Thailand. We are fortunate because the Thai people are quite nice people. We are very friendly. Our food are very nice. Our atmosphere is very nice to be in. The weather is pleasant. You know, our sceneries, our varieties. We have a lot of amusement. We have entertainment.
Yeah.
People come here, they feel like it's enjoyable. It's not like you're not like a robot in a machine that is being controlled so much. We are not so orderly fully, but yet we are not chaotic. We are just right balance of what I call organized chaos. So Thailand is just a relaxed place, and people enjoy being here. So I hope investment will come.
Okay, before we get into this, we have to cap us to shortly because when time is up, then we have to continue tomorrow. So answer me for this for 2 minutes for this. It's all about how to enroll in your institute.
Oh, it's so simple. We have only a huge number of applicants. Our selective rate is really tiny.
Ooh.
We have 10% of the people who apply who can join. Therefore, it's very competitive, almost like Harvard now.
Okay.
But people who come, they seriously wanted to be part of nation building. You can just go online in Nation Building Institute and then inquire and write online application. And the selection committee will inform you. In fact, if you do it immediately, I don't know whether it's live or not. If it's live, then if you immediately, then you would be able to get the response very quick. We are very efficient. We're almost like the Thailand we wish.
Really?
Very efficient.
Really?
We will reply back, and then we'll tell you what the committee said, and then you go on, finish your process, and you'll be informed what to do next. In fact, our second batch started on the 7th of June.
It's a yearly?
No, it's a...
It's a what?
We have a 4 months curriculum.
Months
curriculum. So in each year we have about three classes. NBI 1 we call, NBI 2, NBI 3. So and the number will keep going. So now we are just about to start NBI 2 on the 7th of June.
Which
and
is
we'll end in September. End of September. So anyone who wanted to,
it is our class. That means the time is not the regular time. Evening time for those who are working.
It will be afternoon on Wednesday.
Once a week.
Oh, afternoon Wednesday. And so therefore we try to make it short and sweet, so that we capture the key important ideas. So
our time is up for today, but we still have a very interesting talk with the professor, Dr. Krengsak Kiran Wongsak. Now we have to end up today, and then tomorrow we'll hear more about One Belt, One Road, by your opinion.
OK,
Okay. Right, we end up by thank you so much to Professor Dr. Kring Sak Jarun Wong Sak, President of the Institute for Future Studies for Development in Thailand. Or another one is Nation Building Institute. He's the president of that also. So we end up. Thank you so much, sir, for being here. And
my
see
pleasure.
You tomorrow then. Sawadee ka.
Sawadee ka. Let me tell you about One Belt, One Road.
Yes.
Many years ago, for the first time, I was part of a body called World Chinese Economic Forum.
Morality
was the basis of all this, and therefore one of the manifestations of good morality is that you're not corrupt.